Hey guys, my name is Scoby. Today I'm going to be showing you how to remove vocals from a track in Audacity. I'm going to be showing you step by step how to recreate this method. Before we get too far into this tutorial, I want to mention this is not a perfect method and this will not work for all songs. This mainly works for songs that have vocals kind of in the mid to the background of a track. If your vocals are very in front, it's really difficult to remove them with this method. There is some other paid software out there that will do this method much better, but of course it's paid. I'm going to give you a quick example of what you can expect with this tutorial so you're not going in there with any false expectations. And then I'm going to be showing you step by step to how to recreate this method. Life, while they signal says left, but they're really going right. But who cares? They got nothing to improve upon. So the first thing we're going to do in this case is we're going to select the part of the track that we can use as a medium method that we can listen to use it before and after kind of example point. So in this case, I'm going to zoom in. I'm going to pick somewhere in the middle of the track like I have here. Let's just say from about 145 to maybe 150. So we have a nice little section of a track. For this example, I'm going to be using the track E double B a King. I'm going to leave a link to that in the description down below if you want to check out the original piece. I'm only going to be using about 5 seconds of this for the example. So if you like the track, go check that out. What we're going to be doing is splitting this track into two mono tracks. So as you can tell right now, it is a stereo track because there's a left channel on the top and a right channel on the bottom. To split this track, we're going to be coming over to the left hand side on the track. We're going to be clicking the little drop down arrow right here, and we're going to be splitting the stereo to mono. What this is going to do is create two separate mono tracks that we're going to be needing to affect and change. What we're going to be doing is we're going to be selecting our bottom track by selecting the box on the left hand side, and as you can see, we only have our bottom track selected. From here, we're going to be going to Effect, and we're going to be adding an invert. Now what an invert does is flips the sound waves in the track, so we're going to be inverting the actual bottom mono track. Now by doing this, we're going to affect the audio that we're going to be cancelling out the actual vocals of the track. Now like I said, this will only work for some tracks, and it really has to have your audio in the middle or in the background to make this work really effectively. If your audio is purely in the front and the actual background music is in the background, very quiet, this is going to be a really bad method. So now that we have it inverted, we're going to give it a listen over to see what it sounds like. As you can tell, the vocals are much more in the background, but we also lose some of that quality from the original sound. Now, one method we can do to increase the quality a little bit is to select our bottom mono track that we have inverted. We're going to go to Effect, and we're going to be adding a bass and tremble. From here, we're going to be adding a small bass, so somewhere between 1 and 10. This really depends on your track and depends on the type of music you have, and a small treble if you wish. In this case, I'm going to be sticking to the bass because the song is kind of more bass heavy, and this will just help us vamp up the audio a little bit to make it sound less kind of flat. We're going to click apply and your bass will be added. And now if we give it a listen back over to where we were before. And as you can tell, it kind of vamps up the audio a bit without actually affecting the low quality of the vocals. Now, the vocals are still kind of faintly there, but like I said, this method is not perfect. And unless you want to go for some paid software, this is the best you can get. Anyway, guys, if you enjoyed this tutorial, be sure to drop a like, subscribe if you're new, check out the other videos on the channel. I'm sorry I can't make a more in-depth tutorial on how to remove vocals in Audacity. This is just the best kind of method you can do with free software like this. I do plan to bring out some more tutorials in the future with more paid software, but for right now, I'm really liking what Audacity can do, and I don't really feel I need anything else. But this is great for like karaoke or most things, but it really depends on the applications you're using it for. Anyway, guys, hopefully you enjoyed this. Check out the other videos on the channel. I'm also going to leave my PayPal link down below if you want to support the channel. Until next time, guys, as always, keep it saucy. Peace.